Today I've got three gradient tip tricks for when you're working in Adobe Illustrator that you're going to find really awesome and really neat. So follow along and learn these tips and tricks when using gradients in Illustrator. The first gradient trick tip for you all today is an effect that is going to allow you to make very realistic metal textures within minutes using Adobe Illustrator. So take the rectangle tool by pressing M on your keyboard, and then generate a rectangle like so. Then come down here to apply a gradient overlay. You're going to want to use grayscale colors from the color palette for your gradient today. You can click the gradient slider here in the gradient window to apply multiple color choices. When ready, go up to Effect, Texture, and then use Grain. We're actually going to add two effects, but this is the first one. Use the horizontal setting and adjust the sliders until you're happy. You will notice thin lines that run across your design and your gradient, which does help towards this metal gradient effect. Then apply a new effect, and this time in the texture grain setting, use Contrasty. Again, play with the sliders until you're happy with the metallic effect. Now I feel this looks really realistic, but let me know what you guys think about this gradient overlay. The next gradient trick tip in Illustrator is pretty neat. Again, take the rectangle tool by pressing M, and then make a rectangle. This will work on every single shape, however. Use a stroke only and no fill, and then make sure you have applied a gradient. We're going to make the gradient flow around the stroke of the shape instead of across it by using this setting in the gradient window. If we now resize the shape, and also increase the stroke weight until the very middle of the shape disappears, we can make a shape that has a gradient going around it in this fashion. Now this does look really cool, I find, and it's an awesome gradient trick for you to use in Illustrator. Finally, expand the appearance of the shape so you can resize and manipulate it whilst the stroke stays the same. The last gradient trick tip in Illustrator is one that I've shown here before, but I have a little expansion on it, and that's actually if you take type and place it over a gradient, and then you select both, right click or control click, and then use a clipping mask. This does work, but if you type out of the box area, the type will not show. So use the method of selecting the type, and then in the Pathfinder window, click the top right flight down menu and create a compound shape. Now you can apply the gradient to the typography text like so and still type your text. And there are my three awesome gradient trick tips in Illustrator. So there was today's video on three tricks or tips when using gradients in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video right down in the comment section below. And of course, if you do enjoy my content, drop a like, which lets me know that you do actually find my content useful. And if you really find my content useful, share it on social media so other people can see it too. I'm going to be back tomorrow with more graphic design content, so until next time, design your future today. Peace.